Jesus' name.
Amen.
I'm so confident of that. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
We're still talking about Abraham, and we intend to spend after that some prayers. And people answer prayers in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Well, in Genesis 12, God called Abraham, and I was going to bless him and make him great, father of many nations. And if you look at Genesis chapter 17, verse 1 to 2, God also spoke to Abraham, he spoke to Abraham on those two occasions. Genesis chapter 17, verse 1 to 2. Let me say, when Abraham was 99 years old, the Lord appeared to Abraham and said to him, I am God Almighty. Walk before me and be blameless. Another thing, walk before me and what? And be perfect. That I may make my covenant between me and you, and may multiply you greatly. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Without much ado, you can see what is tied, what is connected to what, to walk before me. I might be your God. I may fulfill my covenant that I may what? Multiply you greatly. That's what God told Abraham, walk before me. And I pray that we shall all walk before him.
Amen.
And that God fulfill his promises in our lives.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Please pay attention and take some little notes. It's not going to be very calm, just with something a little bit pleasant. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
We shall move on to deeper things by God's grace. Amen.
Amen.
We say that Abraham had walked with God for several years since he was called. In Genesis chapter 12, about 13 years or 14 years, Abraham had walked with God for about 13 or 14 years. But as he was about to receive, as you can see, the greatest part of the blessings and the promise of a child, Isaac, God asked him to walk before him and be perfect. Amen. Well, if you look at the scriptures, the idea of God asking human beings to walk with him is not new. Or the choice of human beings to walk with God is not new. We have them very numerous in the scriptures. If you look at Genesis chapter 5, verse 24, we are told that Enoch did what? Walked with God. And in Genesis chapter 6, verse 9, Noah walked with God. In Mark chapter 8, verse 34, Jesus said, if anyone will come after me, let him deny himself, take up his cross, and what? And follow me. It is my belief and conviction that today, all of us, without any exception, will be walking with God. Amen?
Amen.
We'll take our cross and walk with God. Now, I will read a quote. Somebody wrote this, and I think we should listen to it. He said, this phrase, walk before me and be perfect. He said, this phrase literally refers to something that takes place in the presence of or before the face of God. It is to live one's entire life in the presence of God, under the authority of God, to the glory of God. I hope you're listening. To live in presence of God is to understand that whatever we are doing, we are acting under the gaze of God. God is omnipresent. There is no place so remote that we can escape his penetrating gaze. To be aware of the presence of God is also to be acutely aware of his sovereignty. The uniform experience of the saints is to recognize that if God is God, then he is indeed sovereign. Living under divine sovereignty involves more than a reluctant submission to share sovereignty that is motivated out of a fear of punishment. It involves recognizing that there is no higher goal than offering honor to God. Our lives are to be living sacrifices, an oblation offered in a spirit of adoration and gratitude. It is to live a life of integrity. It's a life of wholeness that finds its unity and coherence in the majesty of God. A fragmented life is a life of disintegration. It is marked by inconsistency, disharmony, confusion, conflict, contradiction, and chaos. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And I pray that our lives will be coherent.
Amen.
Amen. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
I will not be fragmented in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Well, if you look at walk before me and be thou perfect, like we said, it is a segment that we look at pretty closely, is the last lap of entering into God's blessings. And God would like to lead Abraham. God would like to guide Abraham. And I pray that God will guide us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So in God's presence, God wants to guide us. What did I say? In God's presence, God wants to guide us. Amen. So we don't just want to do things without guidance. Maybe business, marriage, or decisions, actually very important decisions that will affect others. We don't want to do things without guidance. And God, Abraham needed that guidance. We say that God wanted to help Abraham to finish strong. You may have seen Abraham struggle with unbelief because of the long-awaited child of promise, the seed of promise. Or probably all the efforts of Satan to derail him. God knows that without him, Abraham cannot reach the finishing line. And I pray that we shall reach the finishing line in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Without God, we can't reach that place. There are so many enemies there, and it takes the power of God to destroy all of them. Abraham cannot reach the finishing line. Thus, he had to be where he could be guided. And I pray that all of us shall be where we can be guided in Jesus' name.
Amen.
That is in God's word, God's presence. That's what we are saying. Now, what do I say? That behind the phrase, walk before me, that the intent of God is that he wants to guide Abraham. And behind that for you and I too is that God wants to guide us. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Now, being led by God is not to be treated with levity, that don't treat you with anyhow. Well, whether he needs me or not, I can take decision by myself. In the life of eternity, you don't take God's guidance with levity. For our destiny and that of others may depend on it. In fact, Romans chapter 8, verse 14 says, it is a sign that we are children of God. If we are being led by God, we are what? It's a sign that what? We are God's own children. So it's very, very important we don't take guidance, God's leadership, God's guidance from His presence. We don't take it for granted. And we don't take it, we don't handle it very lightly, with levity. Bible says, as many as are led by the Spirit of God, they are what? They are the sons of God. Romans chapter 8, verse 14. Today, God is still guiding people, but we have to be close. We have to be very close to Him. We have to be in His presence before He guides us. And our lives have to be unclustered. We have to be free from all the encumbrances of life. Our hearts have to be, we have to free ourselves. And that can only be done in God's presence. Amen?
Amen.
Each time we read the Bible, we are praying, we are fasting, we are walking for God. In God's presence, there's an anointing that comes from heaven that unclustered, that loses us from the cares of this life. Amen. And the worldliness all around us, as we are focusing on God and we are doing His will, God also brings support, amen? Without even you praying for it, there is help from above as you tarrying in God's presence. What I'm saying is, forever, if all you are doing in your place of prayer is just thanking God and praising Him, and you don't ask for anything, yet there is still help from above for you. Amen?
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Because as you are praising God, you are taking care of His business. And as you take care of His business, of course, He said, "Let that honor me and do what?" That's what I'm saying. So if you came to this church and you are cleaning this church, you are serving and you are singing around, then there is something flowing from heaven upon your life. Amen. Of course, if you combine that with prayers, the better. And I pray God help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
In His God's presence, there is guidance. Amen. So if any of us is beating around the bush, you don't know what to do, you don't know where to go, and all of that, just go to God's presence. Amen. Begin to enjoy what? The presence of God. Begin to cultivate the presence of God. Have time, spend time with Him. The bigger the challenge or the assignment, the more time you spend in God's presence. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Now take note of this. Jesus was to choose 12 disciples. You know what He did? He prayed throughout the night. Amen? I said, for choosing 12 disciples, sometimes we just take a pen and a Bible and then you belong to that department. You. How much time does it take to appoint people? Huh? Just 5 minutes, I would have done all the appointments. Praise the Lord. But it took Jesus, how many hours? Throughout the night, He was praying. And in fact, when He made the choice, He made a chief, a treasurer. Amen. I'm not saying He made a mistake, but the guy talked to a chief. Praise the Lord. May God help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We say God is still guiding people and He will guide us.
Amen.
If you are a young person, you are looking for a husband or wife, God will guide you.
Amen.
Looking for employment, you are still asking for that. You have an eye on something else. If it is not your own, God will take it away and give something in Jesus' name.
Amen.
God will guide you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
God guides through visions, through dreams and revelation. And I was listening to the Sunday school today, just almost replicating my sermon. Amen. And I say, Holy God, the Holy Spirit is one. Praise the Lord. True visions, true dreams, and revelations, God guides through His written word. That is the Bible. God guides through impressions. It can make an impression on your heart. Something can begin to be impressed. At times, God impresses you as a pastor. God will just impress somebody on your heart. And you pick a phone and say, "Sister Labadi, I just feel like calling you. I have an impression in my heart. I feel like calling you. Any problem? Okay, I pray for you. Blah blah blah, and all of that." Amen.
Amen.
Because you know what is happening on the other side. God has an impression. Now, God can guide us through circumstances. God can guide us through our conscience. God can guide us through well-meaning friends, close associates, and family members. Isaiah 30 verse 21 says, "And thine ears shall hear a word behind me saying, this is the way, walk ye in it, when you turn to the right and when you turn to the left." Amen.
Amen.
However, every leading must be subject to the scrutiny of the Bible. They must not contradict the teachings of our Lord. Especially if you have to do it with marriage and other very important issues, you must not contradict the Bible. Amen. Whatever is being whispered into your ears must not contradict the Bible. By the time what you are hearing is against the Bible, know it's from the devil. Praise the Lord. Is that clear? Amen. 1 John chapter 4 verse 1 asks us to test every spirit. To do what? Test every spirit. And 1 Thessalonians chapter 5 verse 21 says, "Test all things and hold fast what is good." Amen. Most of us are already walking in error because of ideas others have given to us. Peer pressure. They ask you to do things you're not supposed to do or to have done. And when the consequences come, there will be no excuse where it's Sister Lagbaja that asked you to do it. No, you are the one doing it. It's a choice. So when there are suggestions, ideas, either in the spirit or in the dream or anywhere, any suggestions, make sure you read your Bible And look at what the scripture says, especially if you don't have, if it's not clear, God will help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Now, what does it take to be guided? Very quickly, like I said, we'll just go through them. What does it take to be guided? It takes closer walk with God. Amen? It does what?
Closer walk.
Are you walking closer in your journey? Amen? Are you getting distracted? If you want to be guided, you have to be. And I told you, being guided is not ordinary because it's, you're talking about destiny. Not just a woman, it's your own, somebody has been attached to you. And I pray we cannot live unfulfilled lives in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
God wants our lives to be fulfilled. And it takes a closer walk. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I hope you understand what I'm saying. You have to be closer. There are enemies that is if that they eavesdropping. They want to hear what is happening. Amen. I pray that you will not hijack your miracle in Jesus' name.
Amen.
By the time you are so far away, things can evaporate. Enemy can steal blessings. Bible says we are not fighting against flesh and blood, but against what? But they are very operative. Amen. Things can get lost. You have to be closer to the throne of grace. Amen. So that God can speak to you. That we should be willing to be led by God or guided. Amen? We should be what?
Willing to be led and guided.
Even the physical, when the usher says, sit down here, don't say, no. That's my seat. When they say, sit down there, what do you do? You don't stop, you don't start serving with disobedience, man. How do you get blessed? By obedience. Because you don't know the instruction the pastor has given to the ushers. Get this church done this way, that way. You say, well, I belong to the back seat. And you will not go back on it.
Amen.
I don't know why we like back seats. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So we're going to be gathered. Then, trusting in God's integrity that God who promised is able to fulfill. Can you say, God who promised is what?
Is able.
Can we say that? God who promised is able to fulfill. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We trust in His integrity. Then, for us to be guided, we must have listening ears. We must be attentive. Bible says, hearken diligently. Deuteronomy 28 says, don't listen very carefully. Praise the Lord. As you come to the church, you can take some little notes. Listen very carefully. Don't allow your heart to be distracted. Then, if you want to be guided, you must be patient. Patience is a fruit of the Spirit. If you want to be guided, you must continue in prayers. Bible pray until your joy is what? It's full. If you want to be guided, you must dissociate from ungodly counselors. Those who counsel you against good virtues. Those who counsel us against godliness. They are your number one enemy. Pray the Lord. That try to turn God's back against you now and in your future. Because if you sow the seed of evil, you are going to reap it. So disconnect from what? Evil counselors. Are you listening to me? God help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Now, if you want to be guided, you must be obedient to God's direction, instructions. When God instructed you yesterday, the question is, did you obey? Now, if you did not obey that of yesterday, and you want another one today, God will tell you to go back to where? To first instruction. I pray that we will not be the first in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Obedience to God's direction. And of God, God wants to live a sin-free life. Check your life. Am I still living in sin? Sin distances us from our, and blocks our communication with God. When you are living in sin, there's a distance between you already created. It doesn't matter whether you are sleeping in the church. If you are living in sin, you are distant from God. And it blocks communication with God. It truncates destiny. It opens door for Satan to devour. Proverbs chapter 13 verse 15 says, the way of the transgressor is what? Is hard. I pray that your way will not be hard.
Amen.
When our ways are becoming hard, we should check our lives. Amen. You don't blame anybody, you do what? I check my life, you examine your life. Why are my ways hard? Because God delights in blessing us. We said number three on our write-up is that take delight in God. Live your life in His presence. When you take delight in God and you live your life in His presence, Isaiah 58 verse 14 says, Then shalt thou delight thyself in the Lord, and I will cause thee to ride upon what? The high places of the earth, and feed thee with the heritage of Jacob, thy father. For the mouth of the Lord has spoken it. God said He will give us the heritage of the promise to Israel. That will be our portion in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Say a big amen to that.
Amen.
Say a big amen to that.
Amen.
And I pray that God will take us to high places in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
But for this to happen, we must take delight in God. Amen.
Amen.
Now, when we talk about what we are saying is this: apart from your day, your walking 8 hours shifts and those hours, God can bless you mightily. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
There is simplicity with God. As you take the light in Him, anyone that takes the light in Him, begin to receive special instructions, guidance, and help to achieve even this life and to make heaven. I pray God will help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
But if you don't take the light in God, if you just want to do things in your own way, listen to friends, and you don't find time to pray, read the scriptures, what will be limited to page from paycheck to what?
Paycheck.
I pray that God will give us miracles.
Amen.
That will blow our minds in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Jeremiah 29 verse 12 says, then shall you call upon me, and you shall go and pray unto me, and I will hearken unto you. Praise the Lord, son.
Hallelujah.
But if you delight in me, you shall please me, you love my house, you love my work, you love my baby, you are doing things that glorify you, delight in me. He said, then you, when you go and pray, he said, you do what? You answer. I pray that God answer our prayers in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
But if you don't delight in God, there will be a lot of struggling. I think God does not answer prayers. Of course, the enemy can block the way, can be fighting us so much. It may not be the time, but we have to take delight in God. Psalm 32 verse 8 says, when you delight in God, when you have time with Him, in His presence, like God told Abraham, walk before me. If you walk before the Lord, He said, I will instruct you and teach you in the way you should go. I will counsel you with my loving eye. Amen?
Amen.
On you. I pray God will guide you the way you should go in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Now instead of going here, we might be going the opposite direction. In fact, when I just came to the US, I used to go opposite direction. Amen? Instead of coming to Dallas, I'm going to Houston. When I go to, I was supposed to be good. Well, I said, okay, I will just come back. We are laughing at me. Didn't you miss your way here? Praise the Lord. Amen. So life is like that too. Someone is supposed to be being a business fellow. You may choose to do something else. And in that business, you will not make it. So we have to be led by God. Amen?
Amen.
I listen to you. And we have to take the light in. Can we read Psalm 1 together? Psalm 1 to the end, and then we'll pray. Psalm 1, what does it say?
Blessed
is the man who walks not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor stand in the path of sinners, nor see the seat of the scoundrel, but is delighted in the law of the Lord, and his law meditates day and night. You shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water, that bring forth its fruit in the season, whose leaf also shall not wither, and without the Lord shall prosper. The ungodly are not so, but are like the chaff quit the wind trapped me. Therefore, the ungodly shall not stand in judgment, nor sinners in the congregation of the righteous. For the Lord knows the way of the righteous, but the way of the ungodly shall perish.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
I pray the way will not be hard in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
For your peace will be simple for all of us in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Abraham had to enter into his rest, into his blessing, the last lap. As the year is going to an end, please let us practice, let's delight in God. Let us dust our Bibles, begin to read it and study. Amen.
Amen.
Let's find time to pray. You may not be able to pray as the pastor, but at least if it's 10 minutes, 20 minutes, 30 minutes, let it be regular every day. God will help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Now, as you do that, like I told you, you receive help from above.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Then you see the illumination. Things became settled. There's clarity of purpose and direction. Becomes clear. Now, if you don't believe it, try it. Every day, try and pray. And seek God's faith and meditate on the scriptures. You will see purposeful clarity from heaven and guidance. And that will be upon you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Like we told us, you don't get victory outside, you get victory in the closet. Amen. As you delight in the Lord and you are seeking God's face, God settles your problems outside. God deals with your enemies, amen? Outside. And you cannot be holy if you are not a prayer and care. There's no way you can be a holy person and prayerless. Amen. Are you listening to me? So I'm holy, but you don't pray. It's a lie. You need power to deal with sin. Amen. And they are bound everywhere, except if you are falling and rolling in sin, and you don't know. And for our minds not to be clustered, we need the scriptures too. So all of that, all of that takes delight in God. I pray that the Holy Ghost will impress upon us that delight in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So we have to pray for it. Lord, help me to what? To delight in you. Help me to love your presence. Help me to love seeking your face. Help me to love the Bible. Because it's a must. If you don't do it and you don't pray about it, there's something that's wrong somewhere. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Because you can't reach the greater height that God has given you if you don't delight in it. So it is only when you are walking before God that you can lead. You can be led by His Spirit. And if you're not being led by the Holy Spirit, you are none of His. Romans chapter 8, verse 40 says, for as many as are led by the Spirit of God, they are what? They are the sons of God. Are you a son of God? Are you a daughter of God? If you are a daughter and a son of God and you're not being led by the Spirit, then you're not a child of God. So let's get that very, very clear. And so today we are going to ask God to lead us. I will rise. I surrender all.